who's buying this.
Tis I, for when the hour of the midnight munch doth descend upon me, I must embark upon a noble quest to the 7th of the 11th.
And this is an incredibly dangerous stunt in Wyoming, a woman taking a selfie standing right next to a bison in Yellowstone National Park.
You know, before I say anything, let me show y'all something. All right, first things first, she's fine, she's all right, she's good. Guidelines, I don't want no problems. Okay, but like, here's my thing, right? People wouldn't try... Okay, fair. Most people wouldn't try to play Doolittle with a lion, tiger, or bear. Like, most people know better. But for some reason, if a walking tank runs on grass, a lot of y'all think that means sweet. Truth is, most predators, like 99%, they don't see humans as legitimate prey. Most of the time, you gotta convince them that you're worth the effort. This man kicked the bear, he's 100% worth it. The problem is, the animals that get plotted on by predators treat humans like any other threat. Which is why a bison doesn't have to be an avatar to send a child to the clouds. You wanna know what the most dangerous animal in Africa is? Hippos turn hundreds into hashtags a year. Okay, buffalo catch so many bodies that folks nicknamed it Black Death and Widowmaker. Sounds about right. And I know y'all ain't forget about that elephant. And zebras legitimately put more zookeepers in the hospital than big cats and bears. You can look that up for yourself. Whole time, Marty was a real op, not Alex. But yeah, I guess my whole point is, just because an animal's a herbivore don't mean they won't show you God's door. Just because they're a vegan doesn't mean you'll be seen again. And just because they run on...
Well, there it is. I'm finished.
Well, I'm not. Keep it down over there.
Papa, wake up. Papa, 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 papa.
Native girls, they always want to fight. Calm the fuck down, Rhonda Rezzy.
Oh, nah, I'm just kidding. I took my medication today.
Now, who do you, who do you, who do you, who do you think you are?
Because I'm fucking funny, Carlos.
Boy, I really piss you people off, don't I? I did a little profile searching on you, Carlos. He said age 44 and married with a baddie.
Just because you live with your mom doesn't mean you're married, babe.
I am more man than you'll ever be and more of a woman than you'll ever get. Uh-oh. She's lethal.
How long is this going to take?
You can't fuck this up. If you literally, it's so easy, okay?
Okay.
It's literally me.
Multiple bodies.
What?
What?
What does that mean?
A hoe.
Huh?
A hoe.
A hoe?
Jesus Christ.
Like the farming utensil.
What do you mean? It's me, Kenny. Me. Or like what I should be. Future me.
Future you? A good person?
Are you saying I'm doing good now?
Are we talking about present or future?
Kenny.
It was present. If I.
It should be me now.
Okay, a bitch.
What?
is it who you wish you could be?
Yeah.
A wife! I was right!
Where's my ring?
Well, no more interruptions. Looking at you, Seth, now. Who didn't turn off their phone? And also, before we get to that, whose ringer is from 1998? Is this a prank? Is Ashley... Why didn't you just kiss her? Is it her phone?
Was it your phone? What? Was it your phone?
I can't tell... You're smiling in a joyous way. This is why you guys are...
It was not your phone.
That's taking the fall.
She's taking the fall.
So it was your phone.
Bring it? I will bring it, sir.
The
to the throne is dead. Sorrows. Sorrows, prayers. I am stating facts. The princesses have had no babies. The princes have had a record number of babies. Illegitimate whore babies. We had one heir, one royal, and she is gone. Sorrows, prayers.
You hear the twang, and then you assume that it's racist. But that's just what country music is like. Here, look, you're gonna like this one. You'll like this one.
All right. Some folks wear their hats way off to the side with their pants down low and a gun tucked inside. Take their beer by the 40 and their chicken deep fried. I think we all know who we're talking about. The only dark I like is when I turn off the lights. The only hood I love is pointy and white. Can't trust you if I can't see your face at night. I think we all know who we're talking about.
Hey, stop that. That's racist.
What's what? What is racist about it?
The only hood I love is pointy and white?
Yeah, man.
Let's talk about the Klan, man.
The Ku Klux Klan? Are you outside of your mind?
That's traditional country music imagery, man. Like a pickup truck or sleeping under the stars or your dog got killed or your wife left you. Same thing. I would have been fine with any of those things.
What is the difference between those things and what is in the song?
They're not racial.
Hey, you know what? Can I just say something, man? I'm just gonna be frank. You're getting a little like Al Sharpton, like Farrakhan on me right now, man.
Oh my God. Are you serious?
Dude, please. Hey, give me, you know, can I do one more? Let me just do one more, dog. I absolutely promise you that this song is not racist and it's impossible for you to misinterpret it as such.
Okay, it seems like you're about to sing the most racist song so far.
I'm not.
Okay.
Let's go ahead and pop it off, okay? Because you out here telling people that you give me $500 a month, but you don't give me a goddamn thing. Not a nothing. Not a nada. These right here, I had to buy yesterday, okay? You ain't seen your motherfucking kid in over a month over some shit that happened that you out here telling people is a motherfucking sunburn, but really, the doctor ruled it as a burn. And the reason why I have temporary custody is because you have no motherfucking explanation on where it came from or how it happened. But what CPS did do was give you the option to have supervised visits, but you won't take them, okay? But where are these at, though? Where are these at? Because even if that's the situation, which it is, okay, even if that was the situation when it came to me, I'ma still do everything I need to do when it comes to my child, right? Where's this at? Where they at? Where you at, bro? Where the fuck you at? Because you ain't here. You ain't here, and you ain't doing it. The only thing you doing is manipulating motherfuckers around you into believing you something that you motherfucking not. Like, that's what the fuck you best at. Your daily affirmations of what you tell yourself every single day is out of this motherfucking world, okay? You can't even finesse me into giving a fuck that you popping out with the next motherfucking bitch that you probably going around and manipulating other bitches into believing that that's your motherfucking foster sister as if y'all ain't fucking. But you can't even finesse me in the right ways to give a fuck because you don't do what the fuck you need to do when it comes to my child. Okay? You out here telling people all she's selling her shit. Is you salty, bro? Is you salty? Because see, don't nobody know that I had you make your own motherfucking pay so I could sell the content. Don't nobody know that, though, do they? Don't nobody know that you was begging me for my content. Don't nobody know that the reason why I have not talked to you in the last motherfucking month is because I cut you off. Me. That was my doing, not yours. Not motherfucking yours. You over there talking about, oh, it's hard to co-parent with a retard. Bitch, when do you co-parent? When do you even parent? Okay? You can't even distinguish his and he's in a motherfucking sentence, bitch. You want to be funny? You want to hee-hee-har-har? Just make sure that you're more funnier than me before we start going, okay? Just make sure you're funnier than me. You cannot even finesse me in the right motherfucking ways to give a fuck about the next fucking bitch, and that's all you want to do. That's all you want to fucking do. That's all. How many times in the last month have you took your spark car and rolled over to the next person's house? How many times? But you couldn't roll over and get your kids some motherfucking diapers, regardless of how you feel. Regardless of how you feel, why is it? Why is it that you continue to run your bitch ass mouth, but I'm the one that's out here doing it day in and day motherfucking out? You salty as fuck. You salty as fuck because I don't need you. I don't need you. You out here talking about how you get it out the mud. Bitch, you wouldn't have had to get it out the mud 45 times if you would have treated the bitches that you was with right in the motherfucking first place, bitch. You out here popping out with a bitch when really you should be popping out with some motherfucking diapers. And I ain't hating because that bitch is fresher than you are, okay? The creases in your motherfucking shirt, they match the creases in your Air Forces. Fix it, bitch. Fix it. Fix it. And keep my name out your mouth.
Damn.
Genuine ostrich. Three payments.
Oh!
Wait, what? I'm just goofing. New boot goofing.
Oh!
Hi. Why does he look so happy about stealing my shoe?
It's okay,
oh my goodness. The drama, the night duchess.
I think I broke it.
The part three nobody asked for, but everybody needs. Lists of red flags indicating a woman is a bad bet for a long-term relationship. And then he asks, what else? Has tattoos, already has kids, smokes, vapes, nicotine, cigarettes, has guy friends, married in the past, is overweight, doesn't know how to cook, doesn't enjoy daily cooking, parents divorced, wears sexualized clothing, poor relationship with father, no father figure, sexually experienced, good BJ giver, broken cell phone screen, wears makeup daily, wears excessive cake face foundation makeup, been raped or sexually abused. It's a next level of victim shaming. Dealt with childhood trauma. Who the fuck hasn't? Wears hoop earrings, wears high heels daily, wears white nail polish, bad credit, bad teeth, bad hygiene, uses Botox, had plastic surgery, has criminal record, consistently interrupts you, uses Snapchat, shows ass on Instagram, even clothed, won't give you her phone password, won't give you her Instagram or Facebook password. Page 2. Has OnlyFans, uses any drugs, binge drinker or heavy wine drinker, no friends in long-term relationships, no friends from childhood, can't keep friends, bestie friend, friends, is serially single or dick hopper. It's going to be the name of my new band. Has ho friend circle, does extreme crash diets, emotional eater, combative, stubborn, argumentative, puts her career job before her man, has ambitions of being a boss babe, insists on working to maintain her independence, has photos of visiting exotic places, photos in front of luxury cars or designer clothes. Honestly, that's the kind of woman I thought these guys would be all over. Goes to nightclubs, goes on girls trips, has sex on camera. Then he says, what else? Remove anything. LOL. At all the triggered BP people, blue pill, I guess, people downvoting instead of voicing their opinion on what should be removed. They know we're right and can't handle it. Guy. What I love, oh, look who's making an appearance. There you go. Oh, there, okay. What I love about lists like this is that it's a pretty solid to-do list. Like, if you think you're going to be around men like this, just wear white nail polish, hoop earrings, change your phone lock screen to a picture and you, like, when holding up the Leaning Tower of Pisa, fucking done.
Oh my God! I'm gorgeous!
Well, I can't grab your belly forever. Oh my goodness.
Tori, you're doing it wrong. Space, Corey.
Where did you get that?
I could do, 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 do.
What are you doing, Maggie?
Everyone's going to the bathroom. Keep it nice. And then there's Carl. Oh, Carl. Yeah? Yeah?
fan and you go watch the movie Barbie, you're 100% a beta.
And I'm bad like the Barbie. I'm a doll, but I still wanna party. Pink felt like I'm ready to bend. I'm a 10, so I pull in a Ken. Like Jazzy, Stacey, Nikki. All of the Barbies is pretty.
Damn.
All of the Barbies is bad. It girls, and we ain't playing tag. Rad, but he spank me when I get bad. I'm in LA, Rodeo Drive. I'm in New York, Madison Ave. I'm a Barbie girl. Pink Barbie dream house. The way Ken be killing shit got me yelling out like the scream house.
Leave the cats alone. None of that. I don't want to hear it. Oh, self-harm? That's what you're leading to? I don't care. You leave them alone. Arr. Knock it off. That's enough. I'll spank your butt.
What do you have to say? Huh? What do you have to say for yourself? Sancho Pancho?
That's enough.
Naughty dog. You leave these kitties alone. Yeah.
I'm trying to go to the bathroom. Are you kidding me? Are you freaking me? Where did this come from? Matt, we don't even own chicken. Ma'am? Can I help you? What? Honey!
I got fucking plastic tip. And your ass still throwing the motherfucking wall. This is why I didn't buy steel tips. In your ass.
It's too high up. I'm 5'3".
It's regulation. I Googled it. It's regulation. No.
So nothing bad happened?
Mm-mm.
You didn't wreck it?
Mm-mm.
You didn't hit anybody?
Mm-mm.
You didn't run anybody over?
Mm-mm.
You didn't get a speeding ticket?
Mm.
Wait, Jeffy?
Mm.
Why are you making that face?
Mm.
Jeffy, did you get a speeding ticket?
Mm.
Jeffy?
If you made it to the end of this video and you want to see more compilations that I've made, click on the playlist on my channel. Don't forget to credit all of the wonderful people who made these TikToks that I put together in this compilation. They put a lot of hard work on their videos and I want people to see it. If you want to see more of my work, I have my socials linked in the description of every video. Again, thanks for watching.